What are the top 10 signs that will tell you that a company is bad to work for? Well, that's exactly what I'm going to go through in this video. If you haven't seen our channel before, we do videos aimed to help employees. That's employees either in or out of employment. The purpose of the channel is to be very honest, very real, and give you a real scope of what's actually going on. If what we do on our channel sounds like of interest to you, do consider subscribing to our channel. And at the end of this video, if you do like it, give us a thumbs up. So with that, let's get to this video. So let's paint a picture. You're looking for a job. You're either in a job and you're thinking you want to make a change, or you're out of work and you're thinking, right, I need a job, but I don't want to make the mistake of going to the wrong company. I don't want to have my CV saying I was here for a stopgap and have to make excuses for it. I want to make the right choice now. So how do you tell whether a company is going to be a bad choice to go for? Number one on the list is being sold the dream. We've all been sold the dream somewhere along the line in our lives. It might be going out to buy a high ticket item, but spending £200 on something and then regretting it is a little bit different from going to commit to a job. You could be in that job, even these days, for an average of 2 to 3 years. What you don't want to do is go to a job, hate it, and then leave after 5 minutes, because a lot of companies will frown upon that. They don't like looking at people who don't stay in jobs for a very long period. So you don't want to go somewhere because you were sold the dream and then realise that it sounded a little bit too good to be true. And that's the thing you want to look out for. If the hiring manager, the managing director, whoever it is that's selling you the job, says can say no wrong, they're just telling you everything you want to hear and nothing you don't, there's probably something a little bit suspicious about it. What's the catch? No job will ever be perfect. No company will be perfect, and there's nothing wrong with that. But what you want to ask yourself in that instance is, what is that catch? Where's the warts and all here? What's the problem? What's the downside? And if you can't find out what that is, that would ring alarm bells to me. The second thing you want to look out for is when a company is paying above market rate pay, but there isn't really a justification for it. They're paying you better than other companies where you could be doing the same job. Why is that? What's the catch here? And the danger that so many people make, and why it's such a common mistake that people will make when going for a job, is that they look at the numbers, the bag of money, and all of a sudden it gives them blindness around it. They're looking at it straight away going, ah, money, I want a bit of that. But there's probably a reason why they're offering you more money. And it tends to be somewhat along the lines of either they're expecting their pound of flesh for it, in which case if you're looking for a nice, friendly working environment with low stress and low pressure, that's probably not going to be the place for it. But on the other hand, even if it's not that the case, then how much are they asking for their pound of flesh on that? Is it going to be a job where they're going, right, I know your duties say this, but I need you to be doing this, I need you to be doing that, I need you to be waiting hand on foot. Well, you know your weekends off? Yeah, you can't really do them. I need you working those as well. There's a reason why they're paying you more money. Again, ask yourself why. The third sign to look out for is when a company has fake or suspicious employee reviews on websites like Glassdoor, for example. Glassdoor is a website that's often encouraged for potential employees to go and check a company out to see what their reviews are. And this is how it'll work. What will happen is an employee who has left the company or has become disgruntled with the company will put a negative review on Glassdoor. And that review itself might be a little bit too harsh. It might be a bit unfavourable, one star. And often companies aren't terrible to work for, but they may reveal some home truths, but be a little bit harsh about it. And what you'll then find is, miraculously, and for no apparent reason, the following morning, about 10 staff off their own back during working hours within a 40-minute window will all put miraculously contrasting positive reviews on there, saying how wonderful the company is and how brilliant they are. And what will happen is that negative review is then relegated to page 3. Now, if you're looking at companies on there and you're looking for employee reviews and all you can see is 25 positive reviews and then one negative review, you might think, well, okay, it evens itself out. You probably had one lone bad egg in there and then the rest of the people are quite happy. But trust me, most people off their own back don't tend to, for no apparent reason, write positive reviews one after the other. They're things to look out for. And if you see a pattern where every time there's a negative review, all of a sudden there's a whole group the following day of positive reviews that seem to be singing the praise of the company, then I'd be suspicious of that. The fourth thing to look out for is a company that has a high staff turnover. Now, this is a little bit easier said than done to be able to examine, because it doesn't tend to be the case where companies are advertising that they've lost loads of staff. And just because they are hiring, it doesn't mean they haven't replaced loads of staff. They might genuinely be expanding. But the easiest way to do that, and if you don't have it, is using an online social media system called LinkedIn. You don't need to go on there and build up loads of staff. You don't even need to pay for it. It's a free system. But you can check out a company and see current and past employees. If all of a sudden you're looking at past employees, and those employees have been there 5 minutes, but other companies they've been at, they've been there for more a considerable period, either side of it, and tends to be quite a few people with short tenures at that company, I'd ask yourself why. Now, if they're junior, trainees, maybe they're new to the industry, it might simply be the case that that industry wasn't right for them and it's nothing to do with the company. But if they are from the industry and they're going to that company and they're only there for 5 minutes and then going to another company that they are in the same industry, but they stay at that company for a while and you're seeing a little bit of a pattern here and that's what you're looking for, then there may well be a problem. And you ought to look out for those patterns. Does this company have people go there, stay not very long, and then move on to other companies where they do stay for a while? If there's a pattern like that, you know it's probably more to do with the company rather than the employee. The fifth thing you want to look out for is at the interview stages itself. If you're going to a site of a company and they don't give you a tour around, or they don't give you the opportunity to meet the people that you're going to be working with, you want to ask yourself why. Is it because they don't have time? Is it because it's a little bit difficult? Is it because the rest of the team and the site itself are unavailable for whatever reason? Or is it because they're trying to hide something? If you go to an interview and the role involves working at a site, maybe it's a factory, warehouse, plant, something like that, you're going to want to see the environment you're working in. Is it clean? Is it tidy? Is it organized? When you walk around, how do the guys look? Do they look like they have the equipment they need to do their job? Do they look happy? Do they look like contented in terms of the role? It can give you a lot of stuff just by having visual cues. Maybe getting a feel for the place. You'll get an atmospheric feel of the culture, what they're about. Do the guys seem to get on pretty well there? Does it look like the kind of environment that you could see yourself within? The sixth thing that you want to be looking out for is the equipment and the kit that you have available to do your job. If you're on one of those site tours, you might be able to see some of the kit, but you also want to look at where you're going to be working. If it's an office job, a desk job, you want to understand what software, what equipment, what tools you have to do your job with, and what ones that the company will be supplying you with. If the company is supplying you what looks like cheap equipment, the basic stuff, things that aren't going to enable you to do your job as well as you could do, they're things that would may well tell you quite a bit about the company. You see, any company really should be able to give you what you need to be able to do your job properly. Certainly, if they're paying you to do a job, you want to be at least able to do that job as well as you can. And these are things that tell you a lot just from those little signs. So always keep an eye out what level of equipment, what quality of equipment, and the condition of the equipment that you have available to you, because it will tell you a lot more about the way the company operates. The seventh thing to look out for is going to be whether the company give you warts and all. So what I mean by warts and all is the company giving you a full picture of what the company is about, what the role is going to involve, and the plus and negative points of it, the pros and cons, if you like. You want to get a picture of what the company is genuinely like. As I said earlier, no company is the real perfect deal. You're always going to have ups and downs of a company, pros and cons, stuff like that. So if you're dealing with a hiring manager that is willing to tell you that, not only will that give you the bad points of it and you'll see the things that you'll need to compromise on and the things that you might not like about it, and therefore it'll give you that element of it, it also gives you a good understanding of whether it's a place that you would want to work in. Not just because of them being open and honest about it, but also it gives you a picture of what isn't so good about it, what's not so great about it, where you're going to have to settle a little bit more. And that's not necessarily a bad thing, except, as I said earlier, that no job is perfect, but you want to get to understand what the bad points are. Number 8 on the list is understanding the plan. What's the vision for the company in terms of short, soon as you turn up, medium, maybe over the next year, and long term over the next 5 years? You'd be surprised how many people go to a job and then don't really understand what they're getting into. The job day one might be great, but if in 6 months' time the shift pattern changes, they're going to change managers, the company's moving office, relocating, anything like that, your hours are going to change, you're going to want to know about them up front because they're things that are going to affect you and they could potentially give you a reason for leaving moving forward. Certainly, if you're looking for progression in the company or you could be looking for progression in the future, how's that going to work? If a company is giving you wishy-washy answers when you ask about short, medium and their long-term goals, then it means they either are hiding someone or haven't really thought about it too much. Maybe the communication to your hiring manager or to the hiring manager you're speaking to from their own bosses isn't great. But if you can go into a company and can give you a clear vision that's going to be easy, understandable, and sounds very realistic to you over what it's going to be the goals for the short, medium, and long term, then it gives you a picture of what you're getting yourself into. 9. Do you like the people you're going to be working with, or do you like just the prospect? Now, so many people will go into a job looking at the job thinking, there's good money in this, or the company seems impressive, it's going to look good on my CV. There are great reasons for it, but you've got to bear in mind the money you're going to get used to pretty quickly. The CV that has that company's name on it, well, that's going to be on that CV of yours, whether you're there for 1 year, whether they're there for 10 years. The thing that's going to be very apparent to you on a day-to-day basis is going to be the people that you're working with. Now, this isn't so bad if you're completely remote, you're never going to see any of these people. But certainly if you're working within a team or you're going to be interacting with colleagues fairly often in the role and you're going to be dealing with maybe a line manager or other people that are in management above you are going to be dictating orders to you, you've got to make sure that you like those people. What you don't want to do is go and work for someone who you think they seem a bit arrogant, they seem not my kind of person, I feel threatened by them, I don't get a good feel about them, but oh, that paycheck, that sounds good, I might have to sacrifice for that, because you're just going to regret it. The thing is that if that company you're going to is willing to pay you a decent amount of money, chances are somewhere else is going to pay you a decent amount of money. But the thing is, the money's only going to benefit you as being a spike short term. The people that you're working with, the people that you're reporting to, they're going to be a constant problem if they start as a problem in the first place. That isn't going to fix itself. That's going to be an issue you're going to be acutely aware of. So you want to make sure that you like the people, you get a good feel for them. You think, okay, these seem like a reasonable bunch. They seem like my kind of people. I feel I could fit in here. 10 on the list is gut feeling. If you go to a job and everything on paper sounds right about it, they've got the company name you want, they're in the industry you want, the job you're doing sounds great, all the people seem really friendly, but there's something there that's just eating away at you. You've gone for the job itself and someone didn't sit right at the interview. Maybe there's something they said, maybe the way they acted, maybe when you looked around, there's something there that's a little bit of an issue. And even though on paper you're thinking, yeah, sounds great, trust your gut. So many times people have gone for jobs, they've turned up to it, and all of a sudden, even though on paper it's said very well, everything works out right, that gut feeling doesn't tend to go away. If it doesn't feel right, there's probably a reason for it. And if you're really honest with yourself, you'll know why that is. Now, I picked these 10 signs because they're the things that I would look out for. Whenever I've had a job, whenever I've gone to work for a company, they're all very relevant in terms of what the issues were, why I didn't pick a company, or why I end up leaving a company in the end. And also, they're the exact things that being a recruitment consultant, I tend to find are the root issues or the things that people could have looked out for when they went for an interview in the first place that indicated why they shouldn't go for a job. So these are my tips. But maybe you've got tips of your own. Maybe you've got things that you're thinking, well, you check those out. Maybe you've made a mistake in your career. You've gone for a job that you regretted. How would you go about it again? What did you learn from that? Maybe your tips could also help anyone else watching this video to make sure that they don't make the same mistakes. If you've got any tips like that, you're thinking they're things you want to check out, put them in the comments below. If you like this video, make sure you click the like button. If you like the channel and you like what we're doing, then give us a subscribe. And make sure if you do subscribe to us that you click the bell icon and select all so you're not going to miss any one of our videos.